Today we have a situation where we have two women, one accused of adultery and the other caught in adultery. In the reading from Daniel, Susanna is in a situation where she's a beautiful woman and there's two elderly men who want her, and they want her to commit adultery, and she says no. And out of their jealousy, what happens? They falsely accuse her of committing adultery with a young man. And the whole people and the crowds around and her family and friends gather, and some of them accuse her of committing adultery. They've already judged her. Her family and her close friends know otherwise, and they are in tears. In the Gospel of John, Jesus encounters a woman who is caught in the act of adultery. And the Pharisees said, law says that she must die. And what does Jesus do? He turns to the people who have judged her and tells them and asks them the question, who condemns her? Who is without sin? Who of you has the right to judge this woman? In the first reading, evil begins to rear its ugly head. Two jealous men falsely accuse a woman because she won't do what they want her to do. But we realize that through the power of the Holy Spirit, Daniel hears about it and he comes forward and catches the two elderly men in a lie. And the woman is vindicated and they receive their just punishment. Evil reared its ugly head, but we know in Scripture that even though there is evil in the world, it does not prevail. In the Gospel, the Pharisees want to test Jesus, so they put before him this woman. By law, she is to die because she was caught in the act of adultery. But what does he do? He says that the person who was without sin, let them cast the first stone. And what happens? They begin to walk away. And what Jesus does, turns to the woman and said, your sin is forgiven. Go and commit that sin no more. Jesus shows compassion for the sinner. Those who wish to judge or walk away shamefaced. I think the lesson we can learn from this is that we have people who judge without knowledge and people who judge because they are righteous. What Jesus is saying, don't judge. That is my Father's role in life. It is God who judges, not human beings. The other is too, is that no matter how great a sinner we are, that God's mercy and love prevails, and we are asked to go forth, be cleansed, and sin no more. As we approach the time of the resurrection of Jesus, let us know that the Lord died and rose again so that our sins may be forgiven and we may have new life. And like Susanna and the woman caught in adultery, we are all people of God, people who are loved by God, and know that God is with us in our times of trouble.